title of this talk was Poems in Response to Existing Narratives, which I think is a really clunky and not very poetic title. But what I meant by that were poems that are not the personal lyric, although I'm a fan of the personal lyric, but something that I'm increasingly interested in is poems that are responses to history, to current events, to biography, to myth, fairy tale. And I think for a lot of reasons, these are poems that really draw me increasingly. So hopefully as we talk today, we'll think about what those kinds of subjects have to offer us. I'm really thrilled that Carolyn is here because one of the things I'm going to talk about today is how two writers can come at the same subject in ways that are very, very different and very revealing of their own personalities and interests. So there is a poem in the packet from Carolyn's wonderful book, The Embrace. A few years ago, I was talking to a writer, a poet that I admire, that you probably know, but I'm not going to say his name. And I said something to him like, I'm really interested in the poem as a research project. And he just got this horrified expression as if that was the worst possible thing a poem could be. For me, it's really something, again, that I'm really drawn to. Because I think it allows you to follow your own interests. I love learning about something, like right now I'm sort of trying to educate myself in the history of the circus in America, because it's something that relates to my dad. So I think at a certain point in time I realized I was never going to be a real scholar. I don't have the discipline to spend 10 years on whatever project might be a real scholarly endeavor, but I love following my little personal interests. I also found that when I taught, and I've taught for 18 years, I taught mostly seniors at a private girls' school, giving them assignments that made them do something other than write the bad boyfriend or bad girlfriend poem, or I'm mad at my parents today, really was a way for them to engage in the world. And they could also learn a lot more history in a poem than they would sometimes. They are not going to be reading the New York Times. But for example, we did a poem on the Armenian Genocide. Many of them had never heard of the Armenian Genocide, but they knew something about it after having read a poem on that subject. And the other thing I would like to say is that I think for a lot of writers are introverts. I certainly know I am. And writing about personal material, it is our material, but it's not necessarily something we're comfortable with. A writer I really love, Greg Orr, asked people to write at their threshold. And I sort of think, what he means by that is the point where the poem kind of makes you feel uncomfortable or nervous, or I can't do this with language, or I can't do this with subject matter. And I thought, yeah, that really makes sense. But Sharon Olds, for example, has a really different threshold than I do. So it allows you to work with material in a way that is your push, not somebody else's push necessarily. When I was looking through my journal recently, I found these two quotes from Marilynne Robinson's book, Housekeeping, which is probably my favorite American novel. I reread it almost every year. And these just really stood out to me as a way of thinking about why I'm drawn to this kind of poem. One, the first quote was, "What are these fragments for, if not to be knit up finally?" And then it seemed to me that what perished need not also be lost. And I think about these kinds of poems as a way of keeping with us stories that we're really drawn to. And if it's not an act of hubris, also saying that we find a way into those stories. We find a way of braiding our own lives into Frida Kahlo's life, for example. So that's kind of where I am in terms of being drawn to this kind of poem.